Now more of our Channel 4 Action News investigation. We thought Election Day was a good opportunity to do some checking into how elected officials who are already in office are spending your tax money. Action News reporter Matt Belanger dug through hundreds of state contracts and then went to Harrisburg to question your lawmakers about what he found out.
Lots of people like to read the newspaper, but in the House of Representatives, you're paying more than $13,000 for newspaper delivery to Capitol offices.
They're all over the Capitol building, left on tables, filling big newspaper-only recycling bins. This year, Allegheny County Democrat Representative Joe Markosik spent the most on newspapers for his office. More than $2,700 for 5 subscriptions to papers like the New York Times and the Wall Street Journal, including higher-priced Sunday editions.
It's such a very relatively small expenditure. I'm personally like, I'm from the old school and like a newspaper. I'm not the one for reading newspapers or books or other things online. I like my newspaper.
Fellow Allegheny County Democrat Frank Dermody also has newspapers delivered to his Capitol office.
I read those newspapers every day. I think it's important for lawmakers in particular to figure out, to find out and to have knowledge of what's happening in the rest of the world.
Could you read them
state.
Online?
That's a possibility, and we could read them online. I'm old-fashioned, like to hold them, and we should look at reading them online.
When you add it all up, since 2010, the House of Representatives has spent more than $63,000 on newspaper deliveries. In fact, several subscriptions are identified for the House's members-only lounge behind this door, off-limits to the public.
We do not need to be buying politicians' newspapers.
Capitol watchdog Eric Epstein says while the expense may be tiny compared to the state's $28 billion state budget, it's a matter of principle.
12.5 million other Pennsylvanians who make much less than the legislators find a way to dig into their pocket to purchase a newspaper.
We did not just snap our fingers and say no more newspapers tomorrow, but we are cutting back.
But that's exactly what Auditor General Eugene DePasquale did when he took office. He cut off the office's $16,000 a year newspaper order. Now he reads the news on his cell phone, which, by the way, he pays for himself.
We eliminated those. We literally look at it online, or you know, you could look at my own personal phone where I have all the apps on my phone for all the you know, state papers that have the apps.
Our investigation continues tonight at 11 as we uncover a service for which the Pennsylvania Senate spent hundreds of thousands of dollars over the years, which officials now admit was unnecessary. Here's a hint for you. That's coming up tonight at 11. Live in the newsroom, I'm Matt Belanger, Channel 4 Action News.